back with the live show right in the middle of the Miss SC Pageant. Things are really heating up over here, and so we are so fantastically honored to have the currently, or the newly crowned Miss South Carolina team, Allie, McCaslin. Oh my God, we just went over this. Yeah, McCaslin. So, let's talk about your crowning achievement. I mean, just last night, you were walking across the stage. What was going through your head with the competition? How did you feel when you went to as far as chances?
Try to keep to myself and just focus on like how I can be the best version of myself that I can be. And then it worked out.
Yeah.
I'm here today.
Yes, yes. Love that.
You were obviously the best version of yourself last night. And I'm certain that you could be the best version of yourself on that national stage in like 1 month, 2 months.
Yeah, about 4 weeks.
4 weeks. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. So my question for you is, your prelim title was your very first pageant.
Yes.
And then you came to state and took it. You took the crown home. Hopefully you're going to do the same when you go to nationals. But you're going to be there competing with girls from all over the country who've probably been competing in pageants their entire life.
Yeah.
Tell me what you're thinking when you're going up against that, knowing that you're young, you're fresh, and this maybe isn't something that you've done as much.
Yeah, totally. Well, first of all, I'm very nervous about doing that because I know that there are girls who are going to be there for super experience. But I'm really just going to go out there and do the best that I can, do everything I can in these next 4 weeks to really prepare myself to take on the role and hopefully be out this America's Outstanding Teen 2017.
Yes, yes, yes. Now remind our audience, what's your platform?
My platform is Battlers, which is a nonprofit organization that serves dogs to veterans suffering from PTSD and trauma for injury at animals.
Oh, okay. How did you get involved?
Yeah. So Battle Buddies came to my school for my spirit week. That organization came, the head of the organization came to talk to us. And I really just got involved with it because my dad is very involved in the military. And so I really just chose it because both my grandfathers served. And that was just how really coming back, and I decided it was the best thing to do.
Oh, I love that.
I'm certain that your entire family is proud of, including your two grandparents. But my question for you is, tell me,
Yes. So talk to us and our viewers a little bit about how you got into the pageants together.
Well, I will tell you, my mom asked me when I was about 5 years old if I would be in the Louis Sports pageant. And I had no idea what that was, but I said, oh, sure, yeah. And so I did the Miss Casey West Columbia pageant. It was the first time I ever sang in front of anyone in my life, other than in my bedroom in the dorm class. And lo and behold, I won.
Wow.
And then went the next year to South Carolina, and that was probably the second time I sang in front of anybody and won. So it was just, it was absolute fate, destiny meant to be, because there's no other explanation for it. It was just the craziest thing.
Right. Yeah. Oh my goodness.
So tell me, now that you've been to the Miss America organization, you're still a part of the Miss America organization, what do you feel like is the best lesson this organization has taught you and continues to teach other contestants?
Megan, I think the thing that the Miss South Carolina and Miss America organization teaches these young women is empowerment and the life skills, the communication skills. I mean, we didn't have to do the things that these girls have to do. I'm not sure that I would have been able to do it had we had to do all of this. But you can take just about one of these girls off of this stage tonight, send them to a major corporation, they could be a communications director, PR director. They are just really seasoned in that, letting brand, fundraising, things like that. And I think that's the greatest thing that these girls are learning, is that they have the power to make such a huge difference in their communities. And I think it's absolutely fantastic. And yeah, I'm honored to be an open part of it.
Oh, please. Well, so then catch us up. What have you, what have been keeping you busy?
Well, let's see. Okay, over the years, I had 3 boys, then I had 2 stepdaughters. So I was, you know, super mom.
Right. Yes.
And have worked with girls over the years in the great pageants, and recently opened a formal wear store in Lexington, South Carolina called Crown Jewel. And the name came from Crown. And then my maiden name was Jewel. So it was the perfect name. So I opened my shop in September of this past year. Thank you. So it's a lot of fun. But it's just what I love, and it's what I know, and it's what I enjoy. And I love helping anybody that's coming in and encouraging them through the process.
Oh, I love that.
So my last question is, what would be your advice for the newly crowned Miss South Carolina?
I think for the newly crowned Miss South Carolina, oh my gosh, it goes by so fast. You know this, it goes by so fast. So make in all of every single day that you get to experience, because it's over with before you know it. And then before you know it, it's 37 years later, and it seems like it would have never happened to begin with.
Never
memories start fading, and dresses start to deteriorate. But yeah, just so in every single day, because it's an amazing opportunity.
Oh, I love that, Donna. But thank you so much for coming out and chit-chatting with us.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, please make this. All right, you guys. Well, that is our second of 3 Facebook Lives that we're doing from the Miss SC Pageant here at the Township Auditorium. And we will see you guys for the after show after the crowning of the next Miss South Carolina 2017.